Good morning all of you. Today we will start with the exercise 3.6. Okay, first question, listen. Ritu can row downstream 20 kilometers in 2 hours and upstream 4 kilometers in 2 hours. Find her speed of rowing in still water and find the speed of current. Okay, so both you want to find out. So once more you repeat the question. The Ritu can row downstream. Downstream how many kilometers going? 20 kilometers. In how much time? 2 hours. Upstream how many kilometers? 4 kilometers going. That also in how many hours? 2 hours. So you want to find out the speed of Ritu in still water and speed of current of river. Current of the water. Okay, both you want to find out. So these are your variables. The speed of Ritu in still water is one variable and speed of the current of the water is the second variable. So that both I given as x and y. Listen here. Let the speed of Ritu in still water is x kilometer per hour. Speed of current in current is equal to y kilometer per hour. So you are given the both the variables name given x and y. Okay, that is your first point. You want to find out the variables from the question. Now, so downward how much kilometer going? 20 kilometer. Time taken how much? 2. Now you want to connect with the formula. Which formula? Distance travelled is equal to speed into time taken. Or time taken is equal to distance by speed. This formula connecting, here what are the points you knowing? Total distance knowing and the time knowing, but the speed is not knowing. Downward stream speed you want to find out. See here, downward stream speed finding out. I here a small diagram drawn here, just to see. Ritu is rowing downward and the waters flow also downward only, you know. Both are in the same direction. Therefore, the speed will, what will come the speed? The speed will add and come. Okay? The flow of water also in same direction and Ritu is also going in the same direction. Therefore, the flow of water can push Ritu rowing. Okay? So that the both the speed will add and come. Both are in the same direction. Therefore, the speed of downward stream speed. Okay? Ritu is rowing downward stream. So Ritu's downward stream speed, how much coming? X plus Y kilometer per hour. This is the main thing you want to understand. Clear now this one? Okay, both are in the same direction. Therefore, there is a push by the water speed. Therefore, both the speed will add and come. X plus Y will come. And now, upward also I explained over there. Just to see. Ritu is rowing upward direction and the water's flow is downward direction. Therefore, Ritu is going upward, then the flow of water will push downward again. So that what will come? The speed will decrease. Both are in opposite direction, no? Ritu is going upstream and water's flow is downward stream. Therefore, what will come? There is an opposing speed. Therefore, here the upward stream speed, what will come? X minus Y. These two points you make it clear. Okay, so both I written here, downward stream written and upward stream speed also written. Now, time taken for downward stream. What is the time taken for downward stream? See the question again. 2 hours. And what is the distance travelled downward? 20 kilometer. Therefore, we can connect with the formula. Time taken is equal to distance travelled by speed. What's the time taken? 2 hours. So 2. And what's the distance? Downward distance, how much coming? 20. And what's the speed? X plus Y. So cross multiply 2 into X plus Y is equal to 20. Therefore, X plus Y is equal to how much will come? 10. Clear now? Same way, we can find out the upward stream. See here. Time taken for upstream, how much hours? 2 hours. Total distance travelled, 4 kilometer. So connect the formula. 2 is equal to distance, time taken is equal to distance by speed. Okay, time taken is equal to distance by speed. Therefore, time is 2 and distance is 4. Upward stream speed already we written above x minus y. So, cross multiplying 2 into x minus y is equal to 4. Therefore, x minus y is equal to 4 divided by 2, that is equal to 2. Equation number 2. Now, solve the first and second equation. First equation you know, x plus y is equal to 10, and second equation is x minus y is equal to 2. Both solve it. Solving what you got, x is equal to 6 got. All of you knowing, everybody are very expert in solving. The value of x is equal to how much? 6. Now put the value of x is equal to 6 in the first equation. So 6 plus y is equal to 10. So y is equal to 10 minus 6, that is equal to 4. So you got the value of x and y both. Therefore, last conclusion, right? Therefore, the speed of Ritu is equal to 6 km per hour. What you suppose the suppose the x as the speed of Ritu. Not to interchange and write. Okay? So what is suppose the same value, right? Therefore, speed of Ritu is equal to 6 km per hour and the speed of water is equal to 4 km per hour. Clear now? Okay, then we can move to the next question. Question number 2. All the sums are lengthy sums. Question, listen. 2 women and 5 men can together finish an embroidery work in 4 days. Question properly listen. 2 women and 5 men can together finish an embroidery work in 4 days. What is, that is the first condition. From the first condition, you will get an equation. And second condition, while 3 women and 6 men can finish it in 3 days. This is the second condition. From the second condition, you will get the second equation. So, find the time taken by one woman alone to finish the work. And also, the time taken by one man alone to finish the work. That is you want to find out. Did you understood the variable? So from the question, the variable is must clear there. See here, find the time taken by one woman alone to finish the work, and you want to find out the time taken by the man alone to finish the work. One man alone to finish the work. So that you will suppose as x and y. Okay, clear the question? So first condition clear. First condition what is? How many women? 2 women and 5 men together completing the embroidery work in how many days? 4 days. But second condition given, 3 women and 6 men together finishing the work in how many days? 3 days. So from both the conditions we want to find out the value of x and y. So what you want to find out, that we have to suppose. Okay. So listen what we suppose then. Let one woman alone takes x days to finish the work. How many days taking one woman alone to finish the work? How many days taking x days? So one woman alone takes x days to finish the work. And similarly, one man alone takes y days to finish the work. Finish the whole work. Therefore, very clearly you knowing, suppose for example, you are taking 2 days for completing one work. You think, 2 days you are taking for completing one work. Then one day how much work you will complete? 1 by 2. Is it clear now? That is the main thing you want to know here. So, 2 days you are taking for completing one work. Listen, 2 days taking for completing one work. Then one day how much work will complete? 1 by 2 work. Same way, x days are taking for completing one work. Therefore, one day, one woman, how much work will complete? 1 by x. Clear? Are you got clear this point? Yes. So, one woman's one day work is equal to how much will come? 1 by x. This point is clear? Once more, see, listen. 2 days you are completing one work. Then one day how much work will complete? 1 by 2 work. Half of the work only can complete. Clear? same concept only we are applying here. So one woman alone takes how many days? X days taking. Then one day, how much work will finish? 1 by x work will finish. Clear? See here. This is the condition. Okay? One woman's 1 day work is 1 by x. Similarly, one man's 1 day work, what will come? 1 by y. Okay, clear the points? And same way. So, first case you see, how many women is there? Two women is there. So, one woman's 1 day's work, how much will come? 1 by x. And two women's work, what will come? 2 into 1 by x. And how many men is there? 5 men. So, one man's 1 day's work is 1 by y. Then 5 men's 1 day's work will be, what will come? 5 into 1 by y. Is it clear? Okay. Now see the question. Since 2 women and 5 men finishes the whole work in 4 days. Okay. The whole work is completing in 4 days. See here, I have written here. So, 1 day, 1 woman, how much work will complete? 1 by x. Then 2 women coming, how much will come? 2 into 1 by x. That means 2 by x. And similarly, how many men is there? 5 men. So, 1 day his work is 1 by y. Then 5 day, how much work will finish? 5 into 1 by y. Clear? That is, I have written here. But they are completing the whole work in how many days? This is 1 day we are writing. This much, 2 by x plus 5 by y means 1 day's work is written. And then this work is completed by how many days? 4 days. Therefore, 4 into in 4 days together full, they are completing the whole work. Therefore, what I have written here? 4 into 2 by x plus 5 by y is equal to the whole work is completing, one work complete. Clear? Therefore, the equation how forming? 2 by x plus 5 by y is equal to 1 by 4. Are you got clear this question? This part is perfect. Once more you see. So, previous point also once more. Look. One woman's 1 day's work is 1 by x. Okay. Then 2 women coming, then how much work will finish? 2 into 1 by x. Okay. And one man's 1 day work is 1 by y, then 5 men's 1 day's work, what will come? 5 into 1 by y. So that 1 day, how much work will they finish? They will finish 2 by x plus 5 by work, they will finish. But this work, they are the whole work finishing by how many days? 4 days. Therefore, the whole work they are finishing by how many days? 4 days. So 4 into 2 by x plus 5 by y is equal to the whole work they are finishing. So, one work completed by how many days? 4 days. One day, how much completing? This much. Then, 4 day, how much completing? 4 into this much. Is equal to, so that they are completing the whole work. That is why I written there 1. Okay. So, that 2 by x plus 5 by y is equal to 1 by 4. Equation number 1. This equation making is very, very important one. This is very important question also. And similarly, second question listen, same way only. 3 women and 6 men, together they are finishing the work in how many days? 3 days. So, 3 into 1 by x. One woman, how much work are completing? 1 by x. So, 3 women, how much? 3 into 1 by x. So, that means 3 by x. Similarly here, one man, how much work? 1 by y. So, 6 men, how much? 6 into 1 by y. So, one day they are completing this much work. But the whole work they are finishing by how many days? 3 days. So, into 3. Clear? So, 3 by x plus 6 by y is equal to 1 by 3. Equation number 2. Clear all of you? Now, so as usual now, what you will do? This is a reducible form. X and y came in the denominator. Therefore, as usual method, 1 by x we will take it as a, 1 by y we will take it as b. So, see the first equation, how will form? 2a plus 5b is equal to 1 by 4. See here, 2a plus 5b is equal to 1 by 4. So 4 cross multiply 4 into 2, 8a, 4 into 5, 20b is equal to 1. Equation number 3. Similarly, equation number 2, this is, it will become 3a plus 6b is equal to 1 by 3. See here. So that also cross multiply 3 into 3, 9a, 6 into 3, 18b is equal to 1. Now write the equations in the format. So which method we are going to apply here? Here I applied a cross multiplication method. Because substitution method and the elimination method, more terms you want to multiply. So I thought that we can do by cross multiplication method. Okay. So a1 written, b1, c1, all of you knowing. And a2, b2 and c2. Here our variable is a and b. Clear? There is no problem. You may think that here also a coming, but here a1 no. So no problem, sir. Therefore a by the, what is written? b1, b2 and c1, c2. Here b by saying, then constant term first term, then terms of a here. And 1 by writing first terms of a, coefficients of A and coefficients of B. Okay, same format. And now cross multiplying. Multiply terms will be written properly now. Yes. Now, minus 20, 20 into minus 1, minus 20 plus 18. Here, minus 9. Here, 2 minus came, so plus 8. Here, 18 into 2, 8 multiplied. Here, only 1 minus, so minus. Okay. So, minus 2, here minus 1, here difference find out, minus 36. So, find the value of A. A, but for finding out the value of A, you take the term containing A and constant term. So, A by minus 2 is equal to 1 by minus 36. Therefore, A is equal to minus 2 by minus 36. That is equal to 1 by 18. Therefore, the value of A, how much got? 1 by 18. Similarly, find the value of B. For finding out B, what will take a term containing B and constant term. So B by minus 1 is equal to 1 by minus 36. Therefore B is equal to minus 1 by minus 36. Therefore 1 by 36. Therefore B is equal to 1 by 36. Got. This is not our variable. This you given the value variable A and B. A and B we supposed. Original our variable is x and y. So find out it. See here, 1 by x is equal to a, that is equal to 1 by 18. Therefore here also reverse. What you will get, x is equal to 18. Here also reverse them, you will get y is equal to 36. Therefore, number of days required for one woman is equal to how many days? 18 days. Number of days required for one man is equal to how much days taken? 36 days. Okay? Very, very important type of sums. This type of sums can able to ask in 3 and 4 mark questions. Okay? Now we can move to the next question. Because all the questions are lengthy questions. Question, read first. Ruhi travels 300 kilometer total to her home, partly by train, some portion she is travelling by train and some portion she is travelling by bus. Same way, she takes 4 hours. If she travels 60 kilometer by train and the remaining by bus, total how much travelling? 300 kilometers she wants to travel. Okay. Some part she is travelling by train, then she is travelling by bus. Clear? So she takes 4 hours. 4 hours total journey she taken 4 hours. How she travels we can see. She travels 60 km by train. Out of 300 km, 60 km is travelling by train. Remaining how much kilometer travelling by bus, sir? You say how much? 300 minus 60, 240 kilometers are travelling by bus. That time how much total hours taking? 4 hours taking.
clear?
That is the first condition. Same way, see the second condition. If she travels 100 km by train, out of 300 km, 100 km traveling by train. So how much remaining? 200. 200 km is traveling by bus. So she takes 10 minutes longer, that is more than. Here 4 hours, 10 minutes more taking. That means 4 hours, 10 minutes take. Clear the question? Find the speed of train and bus. Are you got clear the question now? Once more read here. Total how much the kilometers wants to travel? 300. But she is traveling by train and bus together. Some portion by train and some portion by bus. So first case she takes 4 hours. In that case how traveled? So 60 km by bus, sorry by train, and remaining 240 km by bus. Second condition. Second condition, how much time taken total? 4 hours 10 minutes. That is 10 minutes more, longer. So that 4 hours 10 minutes taken. That time what done? 100 km travelled by train and the remaining 200 km travelled by bus. Okay, find the speed of train and bus. Okay, move to the answer part. What you want to find out, that we are supposing as x and y. See here, let the speed of train be x kilometer per hour and the speed of bus is equal to y kilometer per hour. You knowing the same time distance speed form, already we done one sum. So time is equal to formula, very clearly knowing distance by speed. Total how much distance travelling? 300 travelling now. Yes, distance travelled by train how much? 60 km. This is we are talking about the first case. Distance travelled by train how much? 60 km. Then what is the distance travelled by bus? 300 minus 60, that means 240 km. Okay. So time taken by train. Time taken by train, what is the formula? Distance by speed. So time taken, so how much distance travelled by train? 60. So 60, what is the speed of train? X. Therefore 60 by X. Any doubt is there? Time taken by train. So time, what is the formula for time? Distance by speed. So time taken by train, that is equal to, what is the, how much distance travelled by train? 60. And what is the speed? X, therefore 60 by X. Similarly, time taken by bus, how much distance by speed only? 240 by Y. Both you got no? But what is the total time taken? How much hours taken total? 4. See here, total time taken, this time plus this time. Total time how much got? 4. Clear now question? So 60 by X plus 240 by Y is equal to 4. Now here you can see, if you are listening, you can see 4 is common. Cancel that 4 throughout. Here 15 by X, here 60 by Y is equal to 1. Equation number 1. Okay. Now same way you try to make the equation number 2. Distance travelled by train, how much? 4 kilometers, 300 kilometers. Distance travelled by train, 100 kilometers. Then what's the distance travelled by bus? 200. Total how much time taken? 4 hours, 10 minutes. Because the distance kilometer you are taken, speed is kilometer per hour taken. Therefore, this 4 hours, 10 minutes, totally you convert to hours. Okay? 10 minutes, sir. Then how much hour it is coming? 60 by 10 by 60. I written here. So this is already 4 hours. So that this 0, 0 will cancel. What you will get? 4 plus 1 by 6. That is 25 by 6 hours. Not to convert to minutes. Why? Because the speed you are taken as x kilometer per hour. Different units are not possible in the same sum. Therefore, all the units must be same. So you make convert to hours. converting to hours, 4 hours, 4 hours plus this 10 minutes, 10 minutes convert to hour, you knowing 60 minutes is 1 hour. Therefore, 10 minutes means how many, how much hours? 10 by 60. That means 4 plus 1 by 6. That means 25 by 6 hours. Clear? Therefore, here time direct I written here. Already case number 1 I explained in detail. Here direct you can write. Time taken by train. How much will distance by speed? 100 by x. Time taken by bus. Distance by speed. That means 200 by y is equal to total time. How much coming? 25 by 6. Here throughout the equation you watch. What is common? 25 is common. Cancel them. Cancel throughout. 4 by x plus 8 by y is equal to 1 by x. Sorry, 1 by 6. Equation number 2. Clear now? Okay. So, equation now as usual what you will do? We will make in the reducible form. 1 by x is equal to, you will take it as a. 1 by y, you will take it as b. So, equation number 1 becomes 15a. You can see once more the equation number 1. See here. Here. 15a plus 60b is equal to 1. What is the second equation? 4a plus 8b is equal to 1 by 6. See. Got now? So, first equation got. Second equation cross. Here, 6 and multiply here. 6 into 4, 24a plus 48b is equal to 1. So, both the equations I written in the standard form. Here also we are applying by cross multiplication method. All of you knowing A1, B1, C1 writing knowing, A2, B2, C2 knowing. Once more we can see A1 is the coefficient of A, B1 is the coefficient of B, and C1 is the constant term. Again A2 is the coefficient of A, and B2 is the coefficient of B, and C2 is the constant term. So here the variables are A and B. Therefore, write down here, knowing here also, here write, and here write. And multiply, cross multiply, cross multiplying once more. See, multiplying from the left top corner. From here, left top corner. All the multiplication you can see. Left top corner. Here also left top corner. Okay. Multiply that. Now see. Minus 60 plus 48 minus 24 plus 15. And here multiply 720. And this multiplying you will get a 1440. Okay, take the difference, put the largest number sign. Here also take the difference, put the largest number sign. Here also take the difference, put the largest number sign. Okay, so find out a by minus 12 is equal to 1 by minus 720. Therefore, a is equal to minus 12 by minus 720. So, you will get 1 by 60. Clear? And second one, see. B by minus 9 is equal to 1 by minus 720. Therefore, A is equal to minus 9 by minus 720. Therefore, you are getting it is 1 by 8. This is, hello, here B, right? B. Here what will come? B. B is equal to 1 by 80. Here you correct please, B is equal to 1 by 8, okay. Therefore, 1 by x is equal to, A is equal to 1 by 60. Therefore, here 1 by x and here 1 by 60, both cases reverse them, you will get the answer, x is equal to 60. Here also 1 by y is equal to, B is equal to 1 by 80. Here also reverse them, y is equal to how much will come? 80. So, you got. So, what you suppose as x? Speed of train you suppose as 60. Suppose as x, that is equal to how much? 60 km per hour. Therefore, speed of bus is also 80 km per hour. Okay. You one or two or three times you watch the video, then very clearly you will get. So, try your level best. Doubt is there, any time you can able to call it. Question number x is 3.7. See now, Exercise 3.6 completed. Now exercise 3.7 optionals. Okay, 4 questions. So first question reads: the ages of two friends, Annie and Biju, differ by 3 years. Who is elder? Not given. Okay, therefore two cases will come. The ages of two friends, Annie and Biju, differ by 3 years. The difference between their age is only given as 3 years. Okay, so Annie's father Dharam, Annie's father's name is Dharam, he is twice as old as Annie. Make it clear. Annie's father, age of Annie's father Dharam is twice, that means two times as old as Annie. That means two times Annie's age. And second condition, Biju is twice as old as his sister Karthi. Clear? Biju is, the meaning is that the age of Biju is twice the age of his sister Karthi. That only the question. Find the age of Karthi and Dharam. Differ by 30 years. Age of Karthi and Dharam differ by how much? 30 years. Find the age of Annie and Biju. Find the ages of Annie and Biju. The meaning is that you want to find out the age of Annie and Biju. Therefore, the age of Annie is one variable and the age of Biju is the other variable. Clear? That is the question. So here question, properly make it clear. The ages of two friends differ by 3. The meaning is that who is elder? Not given. So we will take it two cases. First we will take age of Annie is greater than age of Biju, or age of Biju is greater than age of Annie. Both the cases taking, that is why here question you can see, find the ages of both Annie and Biju. Question listen, answer part listen. Let the age of Annie is equal to X years, okay, and that of age of Biju is Y years. That is clear. Now we can come to our question. First case you see, take a X is greater than Y taken. The meaning is that age of Annie is greater than age of Biju. Age of Annie is greater than age of Biju. The first condition, what is given? The difference between their age is 3. Therefore, X is greater, no. So I written X minus Y is equal to 3. First equation got X minus Y is equal to 3. Clear the question? Yes. Now, one equation got. So for getting the second equation, see the conditions. First, what is given? Annie's father's age is twice the age of Annie. So we can see, I written here, age of Annie's father is equal to 2 times age of Annie. That means age of Dharam. Annie's father's name is Dharam. Therefore, age of Dharam is equal to how much will come? 2 into X. Because age of Annie you are taken as X. Therefore, 2 into X. And second, next condition seen. Read the question. And the Biju, age of Biju is, what is here given? Same make as equation. Age of Biju is equal to 2 times the age of Karthi. See here next point what I have written. Where age of Biju is equal to 2 times age of Karthi. Clear? What is age of Biju? Y. Age of Biju only you are knowing. So age of Biju where written? There you give Y. And that is equal to 2 times age of Karthi. Therefore what is age of Karthi? Y by 2. See here, age of Karthi is equal to what will come? Here, Y is equal to 2 into age of Karthi. Therefore, you want to find out age of Karthi. Therefore, this 2 will divide here. Therefore, age of Karthi, how much getting? Y by 2. So, now you got age of Dharam also got and age of Karthi also got. Clear? Now, you can see your question. Again, see the question. See the second condition, listen. The difference between age of Kathi and Dharam is 30 years. Okay? Difference between age of Kathi and Dharam is how much given? 30 years. Dharam means Ani's father. So very clearly you can see that Dharam's age will be greater. Therefore, next question, see, according to second condition, age of Dharam minus age of Kathi, how much? 30. Therefore, here 2 multiply LCM take here 2 upon 4x minus y is equal to 30. That means 4x minus y is equal to how much will come? This 2 I cross multiplied here 60. Equation number 2. So solve the equations 1 and 2. X minus y already got as 3. So solve 1 and 2. Here you can see we have y, coefficient of y is same, but a same sign. Therefore, we are subtracting sign change here minus, here plus, here minus. So x minus 4x, what will come? Minus 3x. And minus y plus y will cancel. 3 minus 60 minus 57. Therefore, x is equal to minus 57 by minus 3. Therefore, the value of x you are getting as 19. So, now we can find out the value of y. Put in equation number 1. This is equation number 1. Apply here. 19 minus y is equal to 3. So, this 3 shift here. 19 minus 3 is equal to this minus y going this side plus y. So, 19 minus 3, how much got? 16. Therefore, y you got as 16. So, what is age of Ani now? Age of Ani you suppose as x. Therefore, age of Ani is equal to 19 years and age of Biju is equal to 16 years. Clear? Clear now? Yes? Now, case 2 also you want to take it because we are not knowing who is the elder. So, that both the cases you want to do. So, here first case I taken x greater than y. Now, what I taken y greater than x. So y greater than x means what will come? Greater number minus smaller. Y minus x is equal to 3. Therefore, we can write in our standard form. X term first write. X term writing, please remember that here x along with x minus is there. So minus x plus y is equal to 3. Equation number 1. Equation number 2, that will not change. There is no change in equation number 2. See, the equation number 2 same only. Okay, here very clearly you know in Dharam's age is greater than which whose age? Kathi's age. Therefore, the equation here equation there is no change. So 4x minus y is equal to 60. Solve it. Here 1 is plus and 1 is minus. So what we will do? We will add the equations. Minus x plus y is equal to 3 and 4x minus y is equal to 60. Adding them. Take the difference and put the largest number sign. So what will come? 3x plus y minus y will cancel. And here 60 plus 3 is 63. Therefore the value of x is equal to 63 by 3. How much will come? 21. And find the value of y. How to find out? Put the value of x in equation number 1. This is equation number 1. So, minus 21 plus y is equal to 3. Therefore, y is equal to this minus 21 going this side plus 3 plus 21. So, what will come? 24. Therefore, what is the age of Ani? 21 years. And what is the age of Biju? 24 years. Okay, got clear now? So, here we have to do two cases because what is the reason? The difference between their age is only given. Who is elder, who is younger, not given. Okay. Okay, students. Completed now. So, work out and come for the next class. Bye.